Good morning, Help Club. My name is Deb, and I'm so excited to be here today. I'm praying for good coverage in my house because it was really spotty whenever I tried to go on a little bit earlier. So anyway, welcome, welcome, welcome. Today's topic is my absolute favorite thing to talk about. Well, Jesus is my favorite thing to talk about, but today is my second favorite thing to talk about, which is how to be an intentional mom. And so I'm so happy to be here with you guys. As you come on today, be sure to say hello. This is an interactive session that we do every Monday called Mentoring Mondays. And it's just a way that we can get to know one another. And so if you follow Help Club, or if you would like to follow Help Club, just join in and leave a comment and just let us know you're here. And so hi, Danita and Mary Jo. I love this topic too. It's so much fun. Hi, Pam. And hi, Danita. I'm so glad you're here. Okay, so I have so much to cover today, and I kind of decided something that, hi, Mackenzie, that I have to split this up in two videos, which means I'm going to cover this right now in the video. I'm going to cover the content, but at 5 o'clock in the online group, the Help Club for Moms online group, at 5 p.m. today, Mountain Time, I'm going to show my books. And so I have so many books, you guys. You should look at this room. I have so many books because I love reading to my children. I love learning, and our children are grown and they are both lifelong learners. And I can tell you right now that when you read out loud to your kids, when you take the time to cultivate a joy-filled, intentional family home, you will be so glad that you did. And so, hi, Susan. Hi, Shirley. Okay, so today I'm going on live right now. I'm going to give you guys the 10 ways to be an intentional mom. And then tonight at 5 o'clock Mountain Time, I'm going to go live in the online group. If you're not in the online group, please just request to join today. You'll have from now until 5 o'clock tonight to join. And I'll try to tag these or leave notes so you can find it. That's the only hard thing. That group is so big and we have so many things going on. Sometimes it's hard to find things, but if you look today, you'll find it. So I'm going to do a video today at 5 o'clock on how to become an intentional mom, but show resources at 5 o'clock. I have a few resources to show today, but I'll have more today at 5 o'clock. Okay. So now before I forget, I want you guys to be thinking, I want to hear from you. What are some of the ways that you guys, hi Tara, that you guys are intentional moms? What do you like to do? And just take a moment and, you know, we all like to be humble, but I think you can say something that you do in your home that helps you be intentional. So let's just talk about it. You know, I think a lot of us don't talk about what we do in our homes either because we worry that it's not as good as someone else's home, or we worry that maybe we're bragging, but that's just not the way it is here at the Help Club. We want to hear your ideas. So what do you do? Tara Davis, I know you do a lot of things to be intentional. And Susan and Shirley and Christine, I know you guys all do a lot of things. So why don't you guys just share a little idea as I'm talking to get ready for other people to come on, okay? So share your idea. And if I could say what one thing that I feel like was our best thing that we did as a family, besides praying, reading the Bible, everything, that's the biggest idea. And I'm going to share that with you today. That is your biggest number one calling as a mom, is to train up your children for the Lord. Okay, so that we're going to talk about that today. But if you put all that aside, I mean, that's such a big component of what we did with our kids. By the grace of God, everything that we do, any good that turns out, hi Sarah, anything good that comes in our lives is from Jesus Christ. And so I want to give him all the glory for all these ideas because he taught me every one of them. And so just going to get that out there. He taught me every one of these ideas, and he gets the glory because he is the one that teaches us. He'll teach you how to be an intentional mom too. He will teach you how to train up kids for the Lord. Okay, so if I were sharing my favorite way that we were intentional, besides reading the Bible and all that other stuff, I would say we had intentional bedtimes, and I'm going to talk about that today, but my favorite part of our intentional bedtime was I would crawl in bed with the kids at night, one-on-one. I would alternate between kids or whatever, just for a few minutes to check on their hearts. We did a heart check at night, and so when a heart check is, you lay in bed with your kids at night, and if you're not a night person, that's okay. Find another time to just relax with your kids on the couch, or find a time to have tea with them one-on-one. Good morning, Jen and Juliana. And just find some time If you're not a night person, you do you, right? In Help Club, we say you do you. And so for me personally, I tried to take a little nap, just a little 20-minute nap during the day because we had quiet time, which I'm going to talk to you guys about that today. But I would lay in bed with my kids at night and I would just check in. So how are you doing? How are you feeling? How are things going with your friends? You know, how are you as they got older? How are you feeling about guys? You know, like my daughter, I would talk to her about how are you doing, feeling about guys. And our son, I would say, so how are things, you know, are there any girls that you think are, you know, attractive as he got to be older? And we would talk about that. You know, our kids talked to us about things because they knew that they wouldn't get in trouble for what they shared. And they knew that I would never judge them. You know, I tried really hard not to judge my kids and just really come alongside of them as a fellow sojourner on the road to heaven. See, that's what you are. You are a fellow journeyer. You're a fellow sojourner on the way to heaven, and you want your kids to know that about you, that you're not perfect, okay? So I would lay in bed with my kids at night. Hi, Sarah. I would lay in bed with my kids at night, and I would talk to them, and these were our just sweetest moments for us as a family. Okay, so I want you guys to share, what are some ways that you are an intentional mom? I want to hear those ideas, okay? Oh, Danita, we are intentional to include our entire family. I love that. Yard work, housework, projects, to teach them that they have great value and we value their input. I absolutely love that, Danita. That is a great idea. Keep those ideas coming because I want us all to learn from each other, okay? But right now, oh goodness, you guys, before I forget, who can tell me what is happening July 20th and 21st in Colorado? Oh my goodness, you guys, if you don't live in Colorado, you're going to want to come because it is the best thing that Help Club for Moms does all year is our Wise Woman Gathering Retreat. And you guys, it is amazing. And like Mary Jo will be there. She'll be speaking. You know, all the people that you see on the Help Club page, they will be there speaking. They will be there talking and encouraging. And we're going to pray for you together. We have one-on-one time that you get with someone to pray for you during this retreat. And it's a daytime only retreat. So you would have to come. It's a Friday night. Your meals Friday night are, and it's all homemade food. It's delicious. Then all day Saturday, you're on your own for breakfast, but lunch is homemade. Then we have tea time with real china cups, and we go outside on the property here, and we get to sit and journal and write about what we're learning, and it's only $45, you guys. It's crazy. My husband and I feel that we really want to encourage moms, and so we try to keep the cost down. You guys, we are an all-volunteer ministry. We do take donations. It's on our website. We have a Donate Now button, but it comes from our book sales. Buy our books, you guys. Share our posts. Like today, if you guys could click share this video, that would help us so much because we have to pay for our posts to go on Facebook. And so if you could just click share or invite your friends to this video, there's like a little button down there, that would help us so much. But and if you could pray for our ministry, but we do these retreats because we love Jesus and we love moms, but none of us get paid for it. And so we do it. It helps support the ministry. And we only have, I think 16 spots left, you guys, that's it. And so if you want to get to come to the retreat, I'm going to put the link in this video. So check back after I'm done and I'll put the link, or Tara Davis, can you put the link, or Mary Jo, can you put the link in this video? If you guys can't find it, I can find it later and put it in there. But anyway, we're all volunteers, you guys. But I'm telling you, these are the wisest women I have ever known in my life. I have never known women like this. I wish I would have known these women when I had kids in my home because they are wise, they are godly, they're humble, they are encouraging. They don't do this to get their name out there. We all do this to get the name of Jesus out there. That's the heart of the Help Club for Moms. Okay. Oh, thank you for sharing, Sarah. Oh, yes. Oh, Ohio is far, but you can come someday. You should come someday. And Juliana is intentional with her daughter and making sure that she reads her many books. That's so sweet. Okay, I'm going to talk about that too. Okay, I want to pray and invite the Holy Spirit in. Lord, I thank you for this time. I thank you for everything that you've taught to me and to all of these women. God, you are the one that gives us the good gifts. You are the one that gives us wisdom every day. And for my friends that don't even know what it means to be an intentional mom, I pray that they would ask you, that you would give them wisdom, that they wouldn't compare themselves to their friends. God, that they would not look around, but that they would look to you, Jesus, and that they would know that you are going to help them. And so God, speak through me today. Don't let me say anything on my own accord. You know, Lord, I'm going to be in a hurry because time goes by so fast and I only have just a half an hour. And so, Lord, I pray that you would bless our time and that I could finish up whatever I don't finish tonight at 5 o'clock. In Jesus' name, amen. Okay, so if you're just joining us tonight at 5 o'clock Mountain Time in the Help Club for Moms online group, which if you're not in that group, join it. I'm going to finish up this video, whatever I don't get through. And then I'm going to also show, these are the books I want to show today. You guys, I have so many books, but I'm going to show you more tonight. Okay, I'm going to show you more videos tonight. Okay, more books tonight. Okay, so be sure to join me at 5. All right, oh, Mary Jo, Melissa is, Danita's coming from Texas. I love that. Melissa is intentional in communication, prayer warrior. Yes, you are, ma'am. I love that about you. Something very simple that helps Mary Jo. She makes a nice breakfast for her kids and connects with them in the morning. It helps her to stay devoted to her purpose, to stay focused on serving and loving all day. Oh, I love that. And thank you, Tara, for posting that. That's the registration for the retreat. Okay. So can someone tell me when it's like 9:35? Because I don't have my my phone. I have my phone, but I'm using it. So anyway, okay. So the first thing I want to talk to you about in being an intentional mom, the number one things that you can do is to pray. And you hear that all the time with the Help Club. But you guys, I will say pray and read the Bible until I'm blue in the face because it is the most important thing that you do as a mom. It is hands down the most important thing is praying for your family, praying for wisdom on how to be an intentional mom. You know, praying and reading the Word of God. The Word of God speaks to your situation personally. God knows what you're going through personally in your life, and He will speak through the Word of God. Our pastor, I love our pastor, Brady Boyd. He says that the Scriptures are the continuously articulate Word of God, which means they are continuously speaking to your situation. They are continuously helping you in your marriage. That is the most important thing I could ever say, and I'm going to go expound on that a little bit, but pray. Ask God, what does being an intentional mom look like in my home? In Help Club for Moms, we talk a lot about you do you. Please do not compare yourself to me. I've had 25 years of parenting, 25 years to come up with all these ideas that I'm going to share with you. I'm going to share a lot with you today, and I'm going to finish up tonight. But it's a lot to take in one sitting. But God taught me all these ideas. But don't compare yourself to me. Don't compare yourself to your friends, okay? Don't compare yourself to your friends. Just do what God tells you to do. Pretend you're a horse running in a race and you have blinders on and you're not looking around at your friends who seem to have everything all together or their kids are better than your kids. I used to struggle with that because one of my children would always get in trouble when we went over to other people's houses and I was like embarrassed all the time. And I told my daughter, I said, you know what I wish that I could say for you with my parenting advice? And I said to her, honey, just don't get embarrassed with your kids. Just say, because we have these moms in our group that I love, and they say, you know what, he's tired, or you know what, we're having a bad day. And just say it. Don't try to be perfect. Say, yeah, we're having a bad day, or you know what, sometimes temper tantrums happen, and please do not judge your friends. Please do not, do not judge your friends. Do not. Remember what the Bible says? Judge not, lest ye be judged. Ha, does that scare you? It scares me. Don't judge your friends. Just be a friend together. Just say, you know what? I have really hard days too. Let's all just hold hands in this road to heaven together, in this parenting journey, instead of criticizing each other and cutting each other down. Can we just stop? Can we just stop? You guys, stop it. If you're doing it, you know, it's probably the devil telling you that so that your friend will be mad at you and you guys won't be good friends. I mean, it's the truth. Satan hates Christian friendships. So just don't judge your friends, okay? And don't judge yourself. Just say, you know what? We have bad days sometimes. Okay, so you do you. And, you know, ask God to help you remember why you love being a mom. You know, it's so funny. God uses so many things in our lives to help us to know what we should do as a mom. And God used, and this is going to sound real goofy, and so I know it's going to sound goofy to you, but it meant a lot to me. But God used the movie Mary Poppins in my life. And I said, God, I really want to be like Mary Poppins. I really, and I know, doesn't that sound crazy? But I really wanted to be like Mary Poppins in my home. And so if you would ask me my inspiration for parenting, a godly Mary Poppins, if Mary Poppins spent time reading the Word of God or whatever, I really like Mary Poppins. And she made things fun. And that's what I ask God. Pray and ask God, what's important to you, right? It's your family. Is it important for you to have your kids know faithful Christ followers? Is it important for your kids to, you know, all these things are so important. But just ask God to show you what's important for your family. And for me and my family, I wanted to have a godly, Christ-centered, fun home. And so I asked God, I prayed all the time, God, show me how to make my house fun. Show me, bring things into our life that are fun. Help my kids to remember and their friends. See, we just got a new couch, but it's on our old couch. If you can see the green back there, because I haven't had time to move the couch, but this is a couch that was 20 years old and we kept this couch upstairs because they trashed it. I should show you the cushions I haven't had time to move my furniture around, but so I'm like putting the cushions on my old couch. But my old couch is the one I had up here. I didn't want a fancy house. I wanted old stuff so that my kids' friends could just come in and I didn't have to worry about it. And so I wanted my house to be fun for my kids' friends and for my kids. And so we didn't have house beautiful growing up. I didn't have stuff setting out that was valuable. You guys, I did not have stuff like that in my home. My house wasn't perfect. It wasn't decorated very well. I mean, it was nice and I had nice decorations, but it wasn't perfect. But I wanted my house to be fun. So ask God to show you, pray and say, God, show me what kind of a house, like help me to have an intentional home. Help me to be an intentional mom. You guys, you have one shot. And I know this might feel like pressure to you guys, but to me, it motivates me. Like I told my husband the other day, we were driving to Denver. It was yesterday. And I have this marble jar in my bedroom that has Sundays, like this for the rest of my life, one marble a week for Sundays. And I figure, well, if my dad lived to be 84, but my mom only lived to be 50, right? So I don't know how long I'm gonna live. And so I did 82 years worth of marbles. So one marble a week for 82 years. And my jar is not that full, you guys. If you look at your life, you don't have a long life to live. Our life is very short. There's been a lot of catastrophes happen in our community lately, and I'm sure you have them in your community. But I'm telling you guys, life is short. And I know it's probably feels like pressure to think that you only have a short time with your kids. But if that's something that will help you to wake up in the morning instead of being grouchy, but wake up thinking, I have this day. This is the day the Lord has made. We will rejoice and be glad in it. Then I say that's what you should think about. You should think about the fact that you don't know how long you're going to have with your kids and you don't know how long you're going to have on this earth. Every day I prayed when our kids were in our home, I said, God, show me, I said, teach me to number my days that I may gain a heart of wisdom, and show me, O Lord, my life's end and the number of my days that I'd know how fleeting is my life. Those two scriptures have helped me so much. I can't remember where they are because I'm thinking, but maybe Terry, you could write down those two verses. And then the other thing I would pray is I would say, God, show me, help me to remember today why I love being a mom. Help me remember today why I love being a mom. What do I love about being a mom? And if you're a stay-at-home mom, sometimes it's really hard to be a stay-at-home mom because you feel like you're drowning and that you have this college degree or whatever it is. If you stay at home, ask God to help you remember why you love staying at home. Ask him. He will help you. And if you're a working mom, ask the Lord to show you why you love being a mom. Ask him to show you how to make the most of your time with your kids that you have, right? So many people, we all have different puzzles. We should never judge one another, whether you work or stay at home. Nobody should be judging anybody. Everybody does what God, pray and ask God. And if he tells you, you have to work, this is a season, then you ask God to help you to make the most of your time with your kids when you're at home. And no matter if you work or you stay at home, do not spend a ton of time on social media. Be selective what you do on social media. If I was a young mom, I would do the Help Club. You know, I would spend a few minutes and I would read our Bible studies and I would do our videos, but I wouldn't spend the rest of the day on Facebook. You know, we're pretty strategic when we do our posts. Most of them are in the morning and then we're done until the nighttime. And so you guys, don't be on social media all day. It's such a short life. Okay, so number two is spend time reading the Bible. because you cannot draw from an empty cup. You guys, you cannot give out to your kids if your cup is not full. And the world, I'm telling you guys, did I see something about California banning the sale of Bibles? I have no idea. You know, did that really happen? Like, are they voting on that? Or, I mean, you guys, you need to put the word of God here in your heart so that no one can ever take it away from you. You need to put the word of God in your children's hearts so that no one can take it away from them, right? And you guys, the world says so many messages, even in the Christian circles. You guys, you have got to keep your blinders on, even after you watch this video. I want you taking notes right now, but I want you to say, God, what did you have for me in this video? What was for me? Because you guys, you need to do your life according to what God says, and God is going to tell you what to do in your life if you read the Bible. If you don't read the Bible, you're going to sway. You're going to sway because if you haven't noticed, culture changes all the time. Breastfeeding, don't breastfeed. You know, natural birth. I mean, you know, oh, you guys, there's so many voices. I feel so bad for you guys. We did not have that many voices in our head, and if I were you, I would pick just times that you spend with God and that you would say, this is my time with the Lord and I'm going to hear from him. Speak to me, Lord. Come, Holy Spirit. And I would memorize scripture and I would teach your kids those verses. Teach your kids the Bible. You know, the Bible says in Deuteronomy 6, and I don't have the verse reference. Tara, can you help me out on this one too? Hear, O Israel, the Lord our God, the Lord is one. Love the Lord your God with all your heart and with all your soul and with all your mind. These commandments I give you today are to be upon your hearts. Mamas, God's commandments, the word of God needs to be on your heart, because the rest of the scripture says, teach them to your children or impress them upon your children. Talk about them when you walk along the road, when you lie down, when you rise up. In this talk, either right now or tonight, I'm going to talk about talking about the Lord when you lie down, when you rise up, when you're driving on the road. God wants you to be talking about the Lord all the time, because I'm telling you guys from experience with older children, they're going to hear these other voices when they leave your home. They are not going to be like, you have this little time to be speaking into their heart in the power of the Holy Spirit, but they're going to grow up and go to college, and you should not be afraid of that. You should not be afraid of when your kids grow up, because that God that was with your kids in your home is the same God that's going to be with your kids when they grow up. But you need to pray that God will help you to instill godly principles into your children. Okay? That I can't say enough nice things about that, okay? And another thing, and I'm not just plugging our books. You guys, these provide for our ministry. We are all volunteer. I don't get a salary. No one gets a salary. We make money from our books. And thankfully, and from donations that people donate. But in the back of this book and in the back of every book is something called a weekly plan. Okay? And this is awesome. I think I used to do this as a young mom, and the first thing I would do is I would write down and I would pray and I would commit my week to the Lord. And I would say, Lord, where do you want me to spend time reading the Bible and praying? Where do you want me to spend time with my kids? Like, I would write down intentional time where I would spend time with my kids and my husband. I'm going to talk to you guys about husbands. I don't even know how I'm going to get through all this. I'm going to do two sessions. Okay. So anyway, use your weekly plan sheet. It's printed out. It's also free on our website. Just type in Help Club for Mom's weekly plan. But I would fill this out every Saturday night. I would meal plan. You guys, plan your work and work your plan. I learned that from Mary Kay. I love Mary Kay. I can't wait to meet her in heaven. But plan your work and work your plan. You guys, life will just happen to you if you do not plan. I'm telling you guys, it will just happen to you. Okay. So number one is pray. Number two is read the Bible. Number three is disciple your kids. I cannot say enough nice things about the importance of discipling your kids. And I only have one book right now. I have so many I have to gather. The next book we're going through, thank you, Juliana. The next book, you guys, is called The Wise Woman Stays. Thank you, Juliana. My brain is like crazy when I'm doing these videos. The next book that we're doing is called The Wise Woman Stays. The Wise Woman Stays, and it's beautiful. You guys, we're calling this summer the summer of staying, because you guys want to learn as young women, or older women like me, not to give up when things get hard, not to give up on your marriage, not to give up on your kids, not to give up on God, not to give up on church. You know, sometimes we get sick. Sometimes our kids do stupid things when they're older. You know what I'm saying? But we can't give up on God. And so all summer long, we're going to be learning about how to have a great summer. Oh, you guys, in this book, you wouldn't even believe it. We're doing this bingo. It's called the Best Summer Ever Bingo. And it's all about how to be an intentional mom in the summer. In the summer. So we're going to have this bingo and we're going to play bingo. And so you guys get to yell bingo on our page and we're going to have prizes, but it's ideas on how to be intentional with your kids with fun. And also it has a kids bingo that has intentional ways for your kids. And so we're doing that. And we start that study, June. Oh, I'm so bad at details. It's like the first week of June is when we start, and we're going to be talking about it in May. Okay. And be praying that God will help us get our books out there. You guys, it's so, all of us are such busy moms. Everyone that does Help Club is a busy mom. And so we do our best to get the books out there. But any posts that you could share about our summer book, because we're praying that it's going to change lives. So the first week of June, okay? First week of June, okay? But we'll be talking about it in May. Okay, sorry, that was a little ADD moment. But thank you, Juliana, for that. And okay, so I'm going to talk about this one. And then I want to also tell you, I'm going to talk about a ton more resources tonight in the online group at 5. Read the Bible to your kids, whatever way that they can understand it. I love the toddler. This is the bedtime storybook, but they also have the toddler's bedtime. They have a Bible, the toddler's Bible. I love the picture Bible. I love the action Bible. I love the story Bible. I'm going to show you guys those tonight, but take time to disciple your children. Take time to talk to them about the Lord. You want to start it from a young age. Do you remember what the Bible said about Timothy? And Paul said how from a young age, basically that from a young age, his mother and his grandmother were teaching him the scriptures. We are supposed to be teaching our kids the scriptures from a young age. And if you haven't done it, guess what? It's never, ever too late. It's never too late. Even if your kids are older, you know, whatever it is, ask God to redeem the time. See, that's the beauty part about having a God. Our God is that he redeems time. He makes beauty from ashes. He helps us through our mistakes. He fixes them. He gives us grace. That's the God that we serve. You guys, he is an amazing God, and he will help you overcome things and mistakes, and he will help you, and he will make beauty out of your ashes of your life. And if you haven't started, you can start now. Okay, can someone tell me what time it is? Because Jennifer, I'm so glad she is one of the editors. You guys, it is such a good book. Okay, so disciple your children. Now let me just tell you what we did in our family. In the morning, so I got to stay home, and you guys, I would thank my husband all the time. I would say, thank you so much for letting me stay at home. And you know what? At the beginning, I did have to work. It's 9:34. Are you kidding me? Oh my goodness. Okay. I'm gonna probably stop in 5 minutes, and I'll finish tonight at 5, mountain time. So don't miss it. If you work, you know what? You just make the most of it, and don't make your husband feel bad, because if you have to work, just do your best and ask God to cover over things, okay? But I stayed home, and so I was sure to thank my husband, and I didn't take advantage of my meaning in a bad way. I wasn't lazy whenever I was a young mom. I really tried to be a good steward of the time at home that I had with my kids. You know, I didn't watch TV. I wasn't just on the phone all day, but I did make time for my friends, and I did return phone calls after lunch. I always return my phone calls. You guys, return your texts from your friends. Return your phone calls. Make time for friends, okay? But for us, we discipled our kids first thing in the morning. And so, like, what it looked like in my house, I would gather my kids, and it was crazy, but I would crawl in bed with them, and I would read them, like, the picture Bible, or I would read them the action Bible, and we would pray for our day. You guys, you want to be praying for your day. If it doesn't work for you to do that in bed, if you have a large family, do it around the breakfast table. We did that too. So I would have breakfast, and I would actually give our children chocolate and tea after breakfast, and we would sit and we would read devotions together, and it was such a great time, and we would memorize scripture. And then if discipling your kids in the car is so important, and so we would do, we sing Bible songs. That is the best thing ever. Both of our kids came to Jesus. This weekend, I gave my daughter that journal that I was showing to you guys last week. It was a journal that I write prayers in for my kids since they were little. And so I gave it to my daughter. We went to a Broadmoor breakfast, And I gave her this beautiful journal that I had been writing prayers for her all of her life by the grace of God. And I would never, even if my kids were 15, I would still start a journal now. Or if they were in college, I would start a journal now with my prayers and my hopes and my dreams for them. But I shared it with her at the Broadmoor. And I shared with her how she came to Christ because I wrote it down in this journal. And I shared with her, you know, what songs she was listening to on We Sing Bible Songs. And, you know, they knew that We Sing Bible Songs was so important. So in the car, we didn't listen to secular music. I just didn't. And I know that might sound a little harsh, but I just didn't do it. I didn't want my kids having that stuff in their minds. They're going to have it later on when they're older, when they have their own car, right? We can't control everything. But when they were little and they were in my car, they were listening to Christian songs. They were listening to Bible songs that we were singing. And you know, that's the part of the Deuteronomy verse that says, talk about your children when they lie down and when they rise up, when you're on the road. That's what we can do today. And then also, we read a lot of stories about missionaries. I love this book, and I'm gonna show it tonight, Missionary Stories with the Millers. It's short stories about missionaries that are famous around the world. And your kids need to know about famous Christians. And also get your kids together with other Christian families so that they can see, you know what, the Davises are Christian family. The Masts are a Christian family. They believe like we do. You want to always be pointing your children to faithful Christians. Make time for friends. Make time for other families. And it's never going to be perfect. Your kids are never going to get along all the way. Just put that out of your mind. But make time for Christian families. Make time so that you can say, you know what? We're Christian friends together. They believe like we do, because when your kids grow up, the world's going to tell them that people that Christianity has been there, done that. You know, nobody reads the Bible anymore. Wasn't there like something that Franklin Graham shared lately that said that the Bible is an outdated book? You don't want your kids to think it's an outdated book. You want to make it fun and sweet and good, and do not beat your heads over the head. Oh, please do not do this. I hate it when people do this. When your kids mess up, do not make them write scripture out. Oh, please, you guys, don't do that to your kids. The Hebrew says that we want the word of God to be sweet. It's like honey on a child's palate is how it describes us making the word of God for our children sweet. And so in another time when they're not mad at you or screaming because you just gave them a little swat on the bottom or whatever you do for discipline, you know what? Talk about it later. Talk about the word of God. Like, children, obey your parents in the Lord, for this is right. Why? So that all will go well with you and you will live long life on the earth. But talk about it when you're laying in bed at night and say, I love this scripture that God teaches and he wants things to go well with you. That's why you obey your parents and give them candy. You know, we gave our kids candy. We made our Bible time special, special, special. And so, anyway, oh goodness, we are not going to get through this. But the last thing I want to tell you is ask God to bring opportunities into your life to disciple your kids. So we went to this concert, and I'm gonna tell you this story. I'm gonna tell you about what we're gonna talk about tonight at 5 o'clock, and then I'm going to pray. Okay, so give me 5 more minutes. Okay, it's so hard getting everything in. So I used to pray and ask God to show me ways to disciple our children for me and my husband. And I would ask him to bring opportunities into our lives, okay? And so what he did this one time, you won't believe it, what he did this one time. Oh, it was so good. So we love Stephen Curtis Chapman. And so you're so sweet. Thank you for saying that. So for Stephen Curtis Chapman, you guys, he's amazing. And we used to love listening to him. We got a worship CD and we listened to it in the car. But then we bought his new CD, and it was called, it was the one that he did, I think it was Declaration, but it was one, believe it or not. So we got this CD, and I'm going to tell you a little bit more about that. But we were also reading the story of Jim Elliot and those missionaries that went to the Aka Indians, and they were martyred for their faith. We were reading about that story, and then Stephen Curtis Chapman had this CD that came out, and he was coming in concert, and we had already decided to go to his concert. But we didn't know this was all happening. So on his CD, he was talking about the story of Jim Elliot and Nate, all those people that gave their lives for Jesus, okay? On that CD, he had songs about that. We went to this concert. You guys, our daughter was like 10, and my son was sick. And so she was like this, because she was on the edge of her seat, because Stephen Curtis Chapman brought up one of those Aka Indians who killed those missionaries that we had read about. And he was now the leader in his church, and he was giving his testimony, and you know how Elizabeth Elliot went back and lived with that tribe and how it changed those people's lives. And oh my gosh, you guys, they were the most dangerous people on the face of the earth. These Aka Indians were the most dangerous tribe ever recorded. And because of those missionaries, after those husbands were killed, those missionaries went back in and they lived with that tribe and they witnessed to that tribe. That man was standing on that stage, and my daughter will never forget about it. We had to wait in line till midnight to get Minkai was his name, his autograph that was a red X because he didn't know how to write, but she wanted to meet him because we had been reading about that. But you guys, ask the Lord for these opportunities to disciple your kids. You guys are not alone. You know what, if you have a bad past like I do, you guys, my past is horrible. I did not grow up in a Christian home. I didn't know any of the stuff that I'm teaching you today, but God took it. He healed me from my past, and he brought me forward to this life that I have now, and he's going to do the same thing for you. And so I can't believe it. Let me just tell you what we're going to study tonight. Oh, do Awana. Let your kids do Awana. It's worth the investment. I spoke at a Christian university, and I said, a Colorado Christian, and I spoke. It was, I don't even know how many thousands of kids. And I was like, who here did Awana? And they were like, yeah, Awana. And they loved it. And so do Awana. It's a sacrifice. Memorize scripture. Make time in your life to go over those verses. Let your kids learn those verses. That's so good. And then tonight, okay, this is what I'm going to talk about tonight. In the online group at 5 o'clock, I'm gonna talk about setting up learning centers in your home, reading out loud to your kids, planning fun outings for your kids, planning rhythms in your day, intentional bedtimes, fun with their friends, and being intentional with your marriage. I'm gonna get through that tonight. But anyway, so thank you for bearing with me through this long video. Can you tell I'm a little passionate about this topic? Be sure to read our Bible studies this week. They're all about beauty, and they're so wonderful. You guys, they're so good all week long. Join us. Join the Help Club for Moms online group. If you haven't done that, like this page and click see first. You won't see our posts if you don't click see first, because we don't have the money to pay for all our posts to be advertised. We spend $1 per post to have them advertised. That's all we can spend right now. So share our posts anytime you find them. Leave comments. You guys, we need your help. We cannot do this by ourselves. We need a band of women to come alongside of us so that we can change the face of homes in America and around the world. We really want to have a revolution. The world is telling us that it doesn't matter what we're doing in our homes, but God says it matters. And we are raising up Christian disciples for him. In Jesus' name. All right, let me pray. God, thank you for every single person joining today. Thank you, thank you, thank you, Jesus. Lord, I pray that every woman watching will have blinders. They will not compare themselves to me or any of their friends. They will leave this video today and have a little time of prayer and say, God, show me what I can do at this stage, at this season in my life, to be an intentional mom. And God, that they would not judge themselves, but that they would invite the Holy Spirit in to help them, that they would remember that John 15:5 says, apart from me, you can do nothing. God, that you would help our marriages to prosper, that our finances would prosper, that our relationships with our kids would prosper, and help everybody to be able to find the video tonight in the online group and join us tonight at 5. In Jesus' name, amen. Thank you guys so much. And I love you all. And be sure to leave a prayer request. I'll be praying for you. And thank you, thank you. And I'll see you tonight at 5 o'clock Mountain Time. Be there or be square. Bye.